Hello and welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another War Thunder video of mine. This video is going to be very interesting, as it's a very good game and a very bad game at the same time, and soon you will find out what it is. The first vehicle we are actually driving is the 88mm flak truck, so we are heading out for the C zone, as it's some kind of, well, let's call it home zone, for the team starting on the eastern side of the map. But as you can see, in a moment, I'm kind of running into gun depression issues right away, and I can't really fight from this uphill position, at least not the way I want to. So after some initial engagements, I managed to take out this one right here. I decide to actually drive down this hill and kind of go YOLO, because it's a very dangerous position, especially if you're sitting in a truck like this. You're very open to any kind of enemy fire, even machine guns and small cannons. I mean, you know, probably know that. And you're really reliant on your ability to kind of, well, cause serious damage with the first hit or outright killing the enemy, because you can't really afford them to get a good shot at you in return. So, and it's also, you can also call it some kind of whack-a-mole style. So as soon as someone pops up, you need to take him out. And I think taking risks here kind of paid off for a while, at least for this era. I mean, our team isn't very active overall here in this zone, but I mean, we got it under control, and why rush for the enemy zone? I mean, it's pretty stupid, so we are doing quite good here at this position. But as you can see, maybe in a minute or two, the performance of my team at other areas of the map is really lackluster, so I'm getting into a lot of trouble because of this. And here comes the enemy reinforcements. I mean, we completely wiped out the first wave, but they are sure to come back. And, well, here they are. Yeah, this one nearly got me in the back at my ammunition storage. But, I mean, He actually missed his shot, and even if it would have been hit, I think it was a British tank, I think some Valentine or something, and he's just got a solid shot ammunition. I don't actually think he would have been able to take me out with it, so, well, I mean, we all know that British tanks are not really up to scratch in this game, at least the majority of them. And well, here you can see the first effect of my team actually completely while failing at the center zone, because there's boatloads of enemies there. And while I got my zone of influence, I would say totally under control, I really get wrecked by these guys here up this hill. And well, thank you, team. I'm really grateful for this. So well, I actually need to leave my beloved 88mm there and hop into the next vehicle, Panzer IV G. And as you can see, I got myself a nice Girls and Panzer outfit for it. Well, here's a situation I don't really like. I mean, it's a situation where you kind of spawn, and you are directly in view and also in attacking range of several enemies. And I know, well, they kind of are unable to kind of damage you for some time. But I think it's maybe 10 or 15 seconds you got there, but you aren't allowed to move a lot, and you also aren't allowed to shoot. And as soon as you kind of take your first shot, they can actually hit you. And it's a spawn area, there isn't much cover there, so you're actually a sitting duck. This one right here is pretty unfortunate for me. But it happens from time to time. It's some kind of Mexican standoff. We take each other out. So, well, it was a really quick adventure with this tank. But I mean, I got at least, I think, three enemies with it. So 3-1 isn't that bad. Next up is Panzer IV F2. And, well, our team is in a pretty bad position already. I mean, it's looking pretty hopeless. And I still try to all play my part and try to get at least close to the objectives, but it's very difficult already. Since the enemy was in control of the A zone for the whole match, I'm kind of afraid that I will get shot into the flank from this nice uphill position, so I often take a glancing look there to see if I can maybe take someone out who's trying to exploit this nice position there, but well, as you can see, there's no one there. And well, I try to use my artillery as much as I can, but most of the tanks in this kind of battle rating bracket of like 4.0, 4.3 are pretty resistant to stuff like this already. I mean, there's only a couple of light tanks, and well, I think there's not many of the flak trucks actually in this game. And, well, I mean, if I should give you an advice, I think it would be in a situation like this, I think it would be advisable to actually camp it out, you know? Not driving around that much there, because most of the time you're just feeding the enemy. I mean, right now I'm kind of flanking with a storm shit, and I'm also able to kind of attack the enemy in the back there, as a kind of about to spawn camp, or how should I call it? I guess that's the right thing. But obviously, I'm in no position to actually, well, recapture the points there. I mean, it's way too dangerous. With just a sitting duck. And I try to get some damage done, but without any kind of help from my allies. This is, I think, the most I can do. I was pretty angry at this special situation, because the T-34 actually ate 3 rounds of mine and until it closed down. So I lost a lot of precious time there, I think. Well, I don't know exactly what I was planning to do. I think well, I wanted to check out the B zone, maybe if I can get a capture going, but this time I'm getting kind of, I think a rocket hit me there. But that's actually not that important, because right now I'm getting shot in the back by an M4, and I think he would have gotten me anyway, so no matter the aircraft. And well, at this situation, I'm kind of hoping I will still be able to turn around in time, but the reload of the M4 is pretty fast, and as the Panzer IV FG, Panzer IV F2, I think, you got next to no armor, and well, I mean, I kind of had to kind of show in my flank, because my turret was, well, in a, I think my turret bearings or mechanism got really damaged really bad, so I needed to turn the hull at this moment to actually have a small chance of engaging him, but as you can see, well, I kind of failed with this. Well, and while we are at failing, well, I think the one who really failed at this game was my team, because, well, as you can see, a bit later, I got like 18 kills on the end tally. And my whole team together only made to achieve like 9 kills, so they got about just half of my own number, so I guess that's pretty lackluster, to be honest. And well, I was raging pretty hard at this point. I mean, you can see my mouse movements there, as I kind of move back and forth, and at the end I'm already trying to adding up all those numbers of my team. And throughout the game I actually thought there were a lot of players with just one tank or so, but when you look at the details of the chart, you can actually see that most of them used up all the 3 tanks. So, well, like I did, but at least I got something in return. Well, here I am just was counting the numbers. But overall, well, it was a good game and a bad game. I think I can be happy with my own performance, but the team was really a potato team. And, well, that's War Thunder for you, I mean. So, I guess it's time for me to thank you for watching, and hope to see you on the next video. Bye-bye.